Inside CSAIL, the Computer Science and Artificial Intelligence Lab at MIT, it's time to take Chip for a walk. Unlike most robots, whose movements are pre-programmed, Chip learned to walk largely on its own, with hesitant first steps and the occasional tumble. What's more, Chip can practice walking, not just out in the physical world, but also inside a computer simulator.
So that simulator can simulate in about 3 hours of real time. It can simulate 100 days of experience.
The idea of artificial intelligence has been around since the 1950s, ever since English mathematician Alan Turing first proposed a new theory for how to design a computer.
Instead of trying to just wire it up or program it to be like a full adult human, you might build a child machine.
MIT professor Josh Tenenbaum says for decades, the idea of a self-taught machine seemed laughable. Then, in 2012, Google wired together 16,000 computers and showed them 10 million YouTube videos. And the computers learned to recognize something, cats. In fact, without ever being told what a cat is, the computer network developed on its own the concept of a cat. Now, artificial intelligence platforms like Midjourney can draw cats, cats in Boston, cats dancing the tango in Boston, cats dancing the tango in Boston with Governor Maura Healey. And each time a human interacts with these systems, we end up teaching them even more, and the rate of learning speeds up.
That's one of the things that people are a little bit nervous about, honestly, and some people are very concerned about.
What also has some experts concerned is that artificial intelligence is a black box. We feed it tons of raw data, and it spits out a response. But we have no idea what happened inside the box, the millions of calculations performed to get from A to Z. Think about something like a microwave oven. Many of us use them every day without really understanding exactly how they work. That's because we're fairly sure there's someone somewhere who does understand. Artificial intelligence is different because with AI, no one really knows what's going on inside.
No one on the planet can understand.
No one on the planet can understand it.
But MIT's Regina Barzilai points out there are some drugs like lithium, even Tylenol, that no one understands exactly how they work. Still, people use them every day.
This is not the first case when we are using something where nobody truly understands because it delivers the effect that you want. So to me, this is not a concern.
Barzilai supports government regulations for artificial intelligence, but she says politicians will need experts to tell them where the technology is headed. And she says the best experts might end up being the machines themselves. David Bienick, WCVB, NewsCenter 5.